We're ready now to define the derivative. So let's consider a function y equals f of x. We take two points, one at x, one at x plus h, and look at f of x and f of x plus h. And we draw the secant line between these two points, so the straight line that goes through these two points. Now, the idea of the derivative is that we take h and we bring it closer to zero, so x plus h gets closer to x. And as we do this, this line is going to adjust and come down until it becomes tangent to the curve at the point x. So this line will shift down, and then it will be tangent. The slope of that tangent line is the definition of the derivative. So how do we do that? So we define the derivative of the function with this notation, f prime of x, and we're bringing h to zero, so it's the limit as h goes to zero of the rise over the run, so the change in the y over the change in the x. So the change in the y is f of x plus h minus f of x. And the change in the x is x plus h minus x, which is just h. And that's the definition of the derivative. Now, there's another notation, which is called Leibniz's notation, which is very useful in calculus. Instead of saying f prime, we have our delta x. So the difference between x plus h and x is h. So h we replace by delta x. And the difference between f of x plus h and f of x is our delta y. So the Leibniz notation, instead of writing the derivative of f prime of x, we write the derivative as dy dx, which is essentially the limit as delta x goes to zero of delta y divided by delta x. So in the Leibniz notation, we introduce what are called these differentials, dy and dx, which actually which correspond to a delta y, which is a non-zero quantity, divided by a delta x, which is a non-zero quantity, but in the limit that both of them go to zero. So we say the differential dx and dy can be treated like numbers, but they're numbers that are larger than zero, but smaller than any real number, and we call them differentials. So if we have something like y equals f of x, we allow ourselves to take the differential of this equation, which would be dy, then is equal to the derivative of f times dx, treating dx and dy like numbers, even though they're smaller than any real number. So we see this is just the equivalent to dy dx equals f prime of x. Okay, that's the first derivative. We can also take the second derivative if we use the Leibniz notation. So for the second derivative, we would take the d dx of d dx. And what does that look like? Well, that looks like a d squared over dx squared. And in the Leibniz notation, we simply write that as d squared dx squared. Okay, so we write the second derivative as d squared dx squared. So we have first derivatives. We have f prime of x. We can write it as df dx is another notation. We can write it as dy dx For the second derivative, we can write it as f double prime of x means takes the second derivative of the function f. We can write it as d squared f dx squared, or we can write it as d squared y dx squared. So these are all common notations for the second derivative. There's one more notation you should be familiar with. If x was a function of time, then we can use what's called Newton's notation, which would be defining the x dot to be the derivative of x with respect to time. Newton's notation only works when we're talking about a function of time, of the time variable. The second derivative generalizes then to x double dot, then would be the second derivative of x with respect to time squared. Okay. So in order for a function to be differentiable, to have a derivative, it has to be continuous. But not all continuous functions have derivatives at every point. So in order to have a derivative, the slope of the tangent line has to be the same whether you go from the left or from the right. So as an example, let me squeeze it in here. If we have the function y equals absolute value of x, right? Then there's a definite tangent line on the right. There's a definite tangent line on the left. But the point at x equals 0 is ambiguous because the tangent line coming from the left slopes down, and the tangent line coming from the right slopes up. So we say that this function with a sharp corner is not differentiable exactly at the corner. Okay? Other than that, most of the functions that we'll be dealing with in this course, Calculus for Engineers, will be differentiable functions. So let me review. Here, this is a very important video where I define the derivative. So f prime of x is defined as the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. It corresponds to the tangent, the slope of the tangent line to the curve at the point x, and we get that slope by a limiting process. I also introduce Leibniz notation and differentials, so we'll be dealing with dy's and dx's. These are called differentials. They're numbers. They're not quite numbers, but you view them as objects that are smaller than any real number, but larger than zero. Okay? I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.